two cocktails and a sleeping pill, and I'm back in Switzerland to check out the eBee autonomous drone. Unlike with my drone and its convenient rocket and bungee launching system, I nearly mangled my Johnson with this thing. But then again, the eBee is out there mapping disaster zones to save lives.
So at this stage, the drone will do his mission. I mean, we'll start, go to the different target points to take pictures over a defined area. So it will automatically define the flight trajectory, the different waypoints in the air, in order to achieve the target. Wow. Once the flight is done, that means the picture are taken automatically, it will simply come back to the ground. For example, right now I say, okay, go land, and it will automatically come back to the landing point.
You know, I love the fact that we're just sitting here having a conversation, and then, oh, there's the drone just popped in.
Like with the quadcopters, you have to get pretty skilled before you can fly them.
Yeah, here it is. As more it flies automatically, as better it is.
Yeah.
So don't touch it, it do it very well.
Let it do its thing.
And its thing is pretty badass.
All the pictures are automatically geotagged as soon as they're taken. So that's how the software can then stitch them together.
So a lot of the work is done at the computer and setting it up and everything like that.
Yeah. You just start by selecting the area you want to map.
Mm-hmm.
So then you choose the ground resolution you want to get. So this will define the altitude you're going to be flying at. And so you can also plan your flight in 3D. So if you're mapping on uneven terrains, like if you're mapping some mountains or that kind of thing, you use the 3D data. So you're always flying at the same distance from the ground.
Right. So if you're going in a valley or over a peak.
Yeah. So it's safe, and then all your pictures are taken from the same altitude. And you can even visualize your flights on Google Earth and check your flight plan.
Our goal is really to show concretely through actual case studies, actual missions, how you can go bring a drone somewhere, spend a week, and do some real work that then impacts the lives of people. One of our more recent projects right now is a mission that we did in the Philippines. We did this together with a small Swiss NGO called MedAir. They've been there since the super typhoon that happened 3 months ago. They've been building shelters for people. We'd go into villages in the morning, speak with the barangay captain, so basically the mayor of the little village, and explain our technology and that we wanted to make them maps. It was interesting because they may not have internet, they don't have laptops, they don't have computers, but they understand maps. They have hand-drawn maps, they know what power this could give them. We'd launch the drones, they'd fly around, take some pictures, and then we'd take all the data, we'd process it. We'd go to a print shop in the city in the afternoon, and the next morning we could come back and we can present them directly with a map of their village, what it looks like right now.
Because of their bombing and spying, drones have a bad rap. What do you think? Will eBee's efforts rescue the reputation of drones? Or is it better for us just to go on hating drones?